Hi, I'm Achal. Welcome to another course preview of Uvdesk Helpdesk. Now, help your customers to help themselves. Save your time on support by building your knowledge base. Here, we will be checking out the functionality of Knowledgebase in the Uvdesk Helpdesk system. With the assistance of it, you can provide your customer a self-service portal which reduces the repeated customer queries. So, let me take you to the back-end configuration of the Uvdesk Helpdesk. As you can see, I have successfully logged into the back-end of Uvdesk admin panel, and here the very first option is application. These application will going to reflect over here once you purchase the particular module from the Webcool store. And here, as we are having discussion regarding the knowledge base, so in this video we will be checking out the functionality of knowledge base. Knowledge base is something, the self-service portal which you are providing to your customers. And inside the knowledge base, we are having different options, articles, categories, folders, and marketing announcement. So, articles is something which you are used as a saved documents to provide the relevant information to your customers. And in order to create the articles, you just need to tap over this particular button and it will redirect you to a new page. And here you will get the complete list of articles, and here you just need to hit over the create new articles and you can write your own content along with titles. And from here you can also check the preview of the content which you have written over the articles option. Now next, we are having the option of categories. Categories is something which contain the articles, like it is for the identification of multiple articles. You can assign a particular category inside an article. As here, you can check, we have created a category, that is FAQ, and inside this, we have mentioned a particular article. And if you want, then you can create your new category from here. You need to fill out the required information like name, description, and also you can assign this category inside a folder. Now next, we are having the option of folders. As you can see, we have created a particular folder, and folder is something which contain multiple articles and categories as well. As you can see here over the screen, we have created this folder, and inside this we are having 5 articles along with 1 categories, and this folder will going to reflect over the knowledge base, like over the front end of your helpdesk ticketing system. So I will going to show you where this particular content will going to reflect. As you can see, this is the knowledge base, like this is the front end of your helpdesk ticketing system, and here you can find out the information which we have write down from the back end itself. As you can see, we are having this folder along with 1 category and 5 articles. If you are hitting over this, then it will redirect you to a new page, and from where the customer or the guest user can able to fetch the relevant information. This way you can provide the information related to your products over the knowledge base section. Now next, inside the knowledge base, we are having the option of marketing announcement. Marketing announcement is something like if there is any announcement or if there is any message which you want to convey to your customers, then you can create that particular announcement from the backend, and this marketing announcement will going to reflect over the customer panel. So here I will going to show you how you can create the announcement. As here, I am creating this particular announcement, and here first you need to provide the title and promo text, and from here you can also mark this announcement under the particular tag, as I am choosing here the offer option, and from here you can also select the color, and here you need to provide the link text. And next you need to provide the link URL where it will going to reflect, and from here you can mark the status of this, that marketing announcement as publish or draft. And also you need to assign this marketing announcement into a group. As here I am choosing the group as default. So I have filled out the required information and I am hitting over this save advertisement option, and accordingly a screen pop-up will come like announcement data saved successfully. So we have created this announcement. Now I will going to show you where it will going to reflect on the front end, like on at the customer panel. From the knowledge base, customer just need to sign in, and as you can see, as a customer we are having one ticket. Now I will going to assign this ticket to a particular group, that is default. This is because we have created an announcement and we have assigned that particular announcement into the default group. So this ticket must be inside the default group. Accordingly, that announcement will going to appear on the customer end. As here, I am choosing that ticket and I am assigning a group, that is default. Now let me take you to the customer end. As you can see over the screen, this marketing announcement will going to reflect. So this way you can convey your message to your customers as well by making use of this marketing announcement functionality. Here we understood about the knowledge base section, like how to manage your content over the knowledge base and how to convey your message to your customer portal. So this is all about the today's video tutorial. See you in the next one.